Bonjour à tous. Hello everybody, and today you may notice that I am wearing a black t-shirt. It's also just Ravenclaw swag because Ravenclaw rules. But other than that, today we're going to do something a little different. I actually planned this out. Don't be frightened. It's not anything bad. I promise. But we will be using the pause button a lot. But today I wanted to talk about the specific functions of different types of makeup. Now, I hear what you're saying. Makeup is to make people look pretty or make people think they look pretty, whichever works best. And yeah, that is the overall function of makeup as a whole. But why do we wear blush? Why did contouring become a thing? Why do people color correct? Why do people just put this black stuff on their eyelashes? Why do people put this under their eyeballs and all over the face sometimes? Why do people put random colors on their eyelids? Why do people put stuff on their lips? Why do we just put powder on our faces? Individual stuff. And more importantly, why the heck do we use this torture device on our eyelashes? Admit it, this does not look like a fun time. I used to be terrified of these. I'm terrified to use this, and I've been doing makeup for kind of a time. I don't do it very often, so I can't say I'm a genius at this. But at any rate, we basically paint stuff on our face to be pretty or whatever. Not necessarily for certain people, but we put these brushes on our faces with other stuff. Why do we put that stuff on ourselves? We're gonna talk about it. So be prepared for me pressing the pause button a lot. And I'm gonna do my makeup and walk you through why I'm doing what I'm doing according to, well, not science, whatever. Here we go. First things first, hair back, so that your hair does not get makeup in it, because that's common sense. Second thing second, take off your glasses, fool. You may be blind, but you can't do eye makeup with your glasses on. That's just logic. Second, third step, this stuff called primer. Why do we use it? Because that way the makeup doesn't sink into our pores forever. Because it's full of all kinds of chemicals and stuff. And if it was ancient Roman makeup, where they used actual lead, you increase your chances of dying by about 50% just by putting on makeup. So instead, I'm gonna take this. It actually has acne treatment in it, which y'all know I need. So I'm gonna put this on, and we're gonna move on to what comes after the primer. Now, my face is kind of ready-ish for makeup. Am I mentally prepared? No. I am physically prepared though, so we're gonna move on to something called foundation. No, we're not. I'm an idiot. Because I'm an idiot, we're gonna forget about foundation for a bit and do this. It's called color correcting. Why do we color correct? Well, people of the internet, it may look like it, but my face has a lot of red in it. I don't like it. I have a very ruddy complexion, and my under eyes are permanently purple. And no amount of concealer helps it. So what do? You whack out this stuff, this fancy schmancy stuff, and you use the yellow for your under eye where it's purple, and you would like it to be normal, and you put the green where the red stuff is. Complementary colors on the color wheel. Who remembers that from art class? But yeah, I'm gonna do that and see if I can do it properly. Now my skin actually looks like it's normal-ish. Then you move on to foundation. Why do you put this on? Because it makes your skin even and it hides flaws, especially when you have this full coverage stuff that actually scares me. And you wet this thing and you put it on your face, basically. I'm gonna go do that and we're gonna move on to the next step. Now I look like this, and it looks like a really flat skin color that is basically foundation's job. Then we've got this stuff, it's called concealer. You put it underneath your eyes to make it brighter. So instead of looking like I didn't stay up until 3 a.m., it looks like I am fresh and awake and ready to enjoy the day. We all know it's a lie, but I don't have to look like it. It's like football, but pretty. After you blend that disaster in, you move on to powder. Why do we put this powder on? Because it makes us stay and makes all of our hard work worth it. And it doesn't go away after like 5 minutes. You take a big fluffy brush, you put it in the powder, you put it on your face, and hope to God you don't just make yourself look yellow. Hey, now you have a face! Now you can make your eyes look pretty, so what do you do for that? You use eyeshadow. I'm gonna be using these over here. I'm not knocking over a lot of things on my stack of manga. This for the base, because it helps you blend better. And this stuff, because it tells me where to put things. I'll be right back. So I took this white color and used this brush and put it all over my eyelid to make it look like it was light instead of shadowed. Now we're gonna take this brush and we're gonna take this really, really dark brown color and put it in what's known as the crease. It's that place where your eyelid kinda ends and under your eyebrow starts. That's that. After that, we're gonna take this color and put it in the crease too because it says to. Yep, we're gonna do that. Okay, so I've got this eye done. Now why did we do that? What was the point of that? Because we put on this full stuff to make our face look uniform, now it just looks flat. So to add shadows, you put this stuff in it so that it looks like your face is not just a pancake of whiteness or whatever your skin tone happens to be. That's why you do that. After that, you're gonna put whatever it says the lid color is on the lid because it's logical. And I don't know what I'm really doing, so we're gonna follow instructions like the Lego movie said to. I have great idols. To save time, I did the other eye too. So now you can actually see the result. You see the shadows we intentionally created to make it look like my eye has a shape. And now you see this color on it that's kind of sparkly and it looks pretty. And we do that color on the lid to bring attention to the contrast between that color and your eye. This brings attention to your iris and hopefully makes it look pretty. For example, most blue-eyed palettes or palettes designed for blue eyes are browns because browns bring out blue eyes. Why? Don't know, but it works. Then, because we're not done with eyeshadow, thought we were done. Nope, we're gonna put this color in the inner corner. It says to put it on the base, but I already have a base color, so we're gonna break the rules a little bit, mostly to show I can. And we're gonna put that on the inner corner as a little highlight so that we can bring attention to that inner corner and lighten it up a little bit because all the brown needs to be lightened up, apparently. Alright, so that's done. Now that everything looks uniform and even and symmetrical on both sides, we're gonna screw that up with eyeliner because nobody's eyeliner looks identical unless there are gods. Honestly. But I'm gonna do my best. Now, eyeliner's function to bring attention to your eye shape. If you do eyeliner a certain way, it makes your eyes look wider or smaller, or it makes you look like you have an upper lid, or you can make them all smoky and dramatic with it, but I can't do that because I cry far too easily and the waterline never gets done simply because it's far too dangerous. I will be right back after half an hour of trying to do this properly. Note to everyone on the internet, making your eyeliner even is impossible and should never be attempted. Give up. Seriously. And now it's time for this amazing thing. This is called an eyelash curler. Guess what it does? It curls your eyelashes. Why? Because it makes them visible, basically. Other than that, if they're naturally slashed down. And this is because eyelashes are meant to keep stuff out of your eyes. So they're slashed down to keep dust and things out of it. However, we want to bring attention to how long and lovely our lashes are. So you curl them. Somehow. Now that I've done that, you probably can't tell. Guess why? My eyelashes are blonde and invisible. So what do? You put mascara on. So that you prove that putting that metal thing on your eyelashes was worth it. And hey, what do you know? I have eyelashes. Another point to wearing winged eyeliner. It can also make your lashes, if they're the same color, it makes it look like you have lashes from a distance. It's another reason you do it. So yeah, I don't do bottom lashes. You should, because that is really the point. You just do it to show them off. But I screw up makeup too easily, so I'm not doing it and making a fool out of myself by having brown all the way under my eyes. So instead, we're gonna move on to something called contouring that everyone talks about. I found this. Basically, now that we've given definition to the eyes, it's time to do the same thing to the face. Contour is eyeshadow for the face. So you put this darker shade on to create shadows. You put the highlighter on to create lighter spaces. You put the light on top of the shadow and it makes you look like you actually have dimension again. So basically, I put my contour right there, highlight right there. That's how that works, and that's why we do it. Now you can see the difference immediately. It looks like I have a shadow underneath my cheekbones now. It looks like my face actually has a shape, okay? This is why they call it carving out the face. You carve shadows into your skin with this. Plastic surgery? Nah, you need brown powder. That's it. We're gonna leave the highlight for later because it's sparkly and I like it. Also because blush is next. You put blush on it to make you look like you're energized and healthy. You know, the healthy rosy gold glow thing? Yeah, blush. Also, fun fact, they used to do it because it also makes you look aroused. Yep, that's the purpose of blush, and we're gonna do it. And now that you're all rosy and happy and whatever, it's time for highlight. I'm gonna use the one in this one because I like it better than the one in the other thing. They have one in here. They have like a concealer thing, and they have this sparkly one, and I'm gonna use that. Then you add glow to the face with the fan brush, probably, because that's what people use, and I took one from my sister because she said I could. So thank you, Ashley. And that is why you do the makeup you do. Some people do brows, but I'm crap at that, so I don't. I don't even try. And they do that because they're trying to bring out their eye shape and frame their eyes. That's why you do that, okay? What's left is lipstick. Why do you use lipstick? Because that way you can complement the rest of your face by having something on your mouth too. That's why. I'm going to be going for lip liner. And this. Why do I use a lip liner? Because if it's darker, I can add dimension to my lips. Also, it keeps the lipstick from running everywhere. I'm using this color and it's really, really pretty. And it goes well with the natural kind of eye look that I have going on. I think it's natural. I don't know. Makeup's not natural, so I don't know what the hell natural look is all about. But we're gonna do this, and I'll show you the final look. That's the lips. Why do we really do this? It makes our lips look kissable, apparently. I've never been kissed because of my lipstick, but you know, I'm single as hell, as we established yesterday. So, no one's kissing me anyway. What do we do to keep all of this in place? Because we spent a good half hour trying to put this on? Yeah, we spray our faces and then it melts into it. And then we go and do whatever. Or if you're me, wipe it off and go to sleep. But it stays on. And that concludes everything. So we're just gonna do the whole fancy schmancy spray thing that somehow makes Nikki Tutorials and Jeffree Star look amazing. Probably not nearly as sexy as when they do it, but you know what? I tried. When you see me wearing makeup, know I tried. Then you take your hair down. You do this, and you realize you're still blind. So you pause the video so you can get your glasses on. Thank you guys so much for watching this long video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something. I googled some of these things, others I just assumed, and we're gonna go with yes, I'm right. But if you'd like to, go ahead and google why we do the things we do. And it's just interesting to think about. So I hope you all enjoyed. I hope you had a great day. I had a good day. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Au revoir, guys. Bye, everybody.